Okay, I had to go to the room one more time.
No. I had to get a consensus.
You gotta balance this table. This is crazy balancing right now.
That's compoundable.
You make it so much worse because he just comment on it. Like, I don't know if you notice how uncool I'm being right now. I'm gonna keep talking about it until you notice.
Shit.
Oh, I was trying to balance it, but it just started shaking crazy.
That's my only flaw. I always tell you when you can take the goo points. You ready?
Yeah. Nope.
Okay.
I have nobody in the same, baby.
I'm on autopilot.
Posters opened up for entertainment manager. I could do that. That sounds great.
That's
whatever this job is, entertainment manager.
That's not for you,
Jay. That's not
for you. What are you talking about? Organising cultural events for visiting business partners? That is so me.
It's not, though. It's really not for you.
Oh, I'm not talking to you for. Where's Roy?
Not in yet.
Is he still moping about after that girl?
Making a bet.
Never. Thank God he can't play guitar. Have you seen the pictures?
I feel like everything's upgraded, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there's a buttload.
Resolution's clear.
And they have better computers, don't they?
Oh, yeah. Someone broke up with Stalin.
Such a shame. I've never seen him happier than he's been the last few months and now. Oh, hi, Roy.
It's okay, you're obviously talking about me.
No.
It's fine. I realize I haven't been the easiest person to be around the last few weeks. But I really feel like I've turned the corner now. I really do. So if we can all just carry on. No, I feel like I've come out the other side of it now. So everything's gonna be okay from here on in. My heart hurts.
You do seem better than yesterday. But Roy, you've got to snap out of this.
I know.
Some things just don't work out. I know you're not used to being in a long-term relationship.
It's really rare for me.
It's so rare. But take it from
so
me.
So rare.
Most of them just don't work out.
She's right, Roy.
And how would you know?
I do all right.
Really all right?
Well, if you must know, I met a girl on holiday.
They're always on holiday, aren't they, Moss?
Oh, shut up, Dumpo! The elephant who got dumped!
Hey!
He snapped real fast, babe.
I'm all right. I mean, I'm still a bit... You know, she never said goodbye, so I just gotta... And, you know, it still just hurts just a little bit whenever I think about her. So I guess all I'll have to do is just never think about her. See you, Poops! Oh, she used to love that ad.
It's not for you, Jim.
Entertainment position. Why is everyone saying that, though?
Do you know what that involves?
Well, from what I can gather, it's just organising cultural events for out-of-town business partners.
That's right, yes. It's not for you.
Mr. Renham, I will not work with prostitutes.
No. These are feminists.
You can dress it up however you like.
Oh,
they still sleep with men for money. I'm sorry, no offence. But I don't charge for these potatoes. And I don't like women who do.
Don't listen to her. The bitch is crazy.
This is crazy.
Douglas wants me to see out the week. A whole week. In the company of those idiots. Culture's out, restaurants are out. God, this is a nightmare.
Mayday.
Mayday.
What are they like with their bawdy talk and roughhousing and their wandering hands and breath in the morning? Oh, I'd like to see them have the babies.
What are you getting at, Moss?
Well, unless I'm very much mistaken, this seems to be a problem for which you need the male perspective.
Do you know any men?
You want a good time, right? One that walks on the wild side without compromising your principles?
Yeah, that's exactly what I want.
Then you got it, baby! which is why the game needs a 20-sided dice.
Oh my god, man, he's gonna make them play.
I've not understood a word you've just said. What is it, some sort of computer game? In a sense, except it uses the most powerful processor known to man, the human mind.
Mm-hmm. In your imagination.
I'm not a player, but I am playing.
He sort of tells us what's happening.
I will be your guide. Through my words, you will experience the land of Elfenheart.
Yeah.
From the mighty mountains that border the goblin wastelands, to the sewers that run like a spiderweb through the city of Jandor. I, gentlemen, will be your eyes. I will be everyone you meet, every creature you encounter, every trap you spring.
What about him? What's this business with a face like a slapped ass?
I'm sorry, I just came out of a long-term relationship, some of it. She was the greatest woman I've ever met, and I'm never gonna see her again, but it's fine, hon. She never said goodbye, so I'm not gonna bore you with it.
See that you bloody don't.
I still don't understand what this game is!
It seems gay. The dragon's gay, Phil.
The dragon's gay.
Mighty warrior priests wielding golden staffs. I suppose they're gay too.
I suppose they're gay too.
Here are your character sheets. John 1, you're a unicorn man. John 2, you're a wood fairy. And Phil, you're the gypsy assassin Esmeralda.
I'm a woman. I don't think I want to be a woman.
Just go with it. It will end.
So, gentlemen, are you prepared to open the doors to your minds and travel to worlds hitherto undreamed of?
Hitherto undreamed of.
Hey. Look at those fun bags.
That's a giant beer.
Everybody doing okay? Yeah. You good for drinks?
Yeah.
Loosen up. There's a role-playing party.
Jen, can I have a word? I don't think I want to hang with these guys.
Ah, come on, Phil. These guys are the best. They're going to do things tonight that'll blow your mind.
Really?
Look at them. They're young, they're keen, and all they want to do is show you a good time. So get back there before you hurt their feelings. Could I steal the lovely Roy for a sec?
Yeah, calm down, babe.
Yeah,
oh, thanks, Jen. That was all getting a little bit...
What do you think you're doing?
What?
Bringing everyone down with your private life.
Your man?
Yeah. Here for a good time.
I'm afraid of
that face. Who'd want to role play with that face?
That face.
I'm sorry, Jen. I'm not feeling it tonight.
Then fake it, sweetheart.
Fake it.
You're getting good money for this.
Getting good money for this.
If anyone get a deposit for a flat, leave those bad memories behind.
Yeah. I'll try harder, Jen.
Okay. Good girl.
Good girl. Don't get out there.
Go there and show those Johns a good time.
You just had a chance of a critical. Remember the talking bunny that gave me that magic bracelet?
Yeah, that bunny thing gave him that thing.
Absolutely right. Roll them.
Yes! Oh. I do it!
Hit. The knife cleaves his head in twain, and some of his brains runneth down John 2's invisibility cloak.
Eiffel Tower!
Unfortunately, he wasn't alone.
Oh.
Tis the dreaded Imperial Guard that calls to all of Queen Eliza's troops. At their head, someone you recognise.
Well. If it isn't the adventurers, what have been causing me all this bother?
Lucius Santana.
The very same.
Stand your men down, Lucius. We have no quarrel with you.
Quarrel?
I just came to see
how a mismatched bunch of raggle-taggle adventurers bested some of the deadliest criminals in Brackenwood.
Oh, that's us!
Maybe act like a girl.
And if you ever want to join the palace guard, you know where I am.
The palace guard.
Fallon's got
sword, and my staff, and my bunny bracelet.
And whatever it is that I am.
Whatever it is.
The mist clears. You see a lone female figure.
Lads.
It's running mysterious.
Running. That's what it's going for. Running mysterious.
Running mysterious.
Hello, Dark Harden.
Hello. Who goes there?
'Tis I, Queen Eliza Eldritch of the Elves, who cruelly jilted you not 3 moons ago.
Why are you making this personal?
Don't do this.
Don't do this.
Just go with it, Ron.
Oh, he used the name of his
yeah.
Hello, my queen. How are you?
I'm fine. You look well.
So do you.
Does she? Yeah, she does actually.
Does she?
So, what are you up to?
Oh, you know, just keep them busy. Missing you a little bit. Yourself?
Usual boring pageantry. You know how the people of Pipsy Hollow love a parade.
What are you doing here?
Sorry. Sorry. Bear with me.
Let me get the red sound.
I sense a sadness in you.
Close my eyes. It's still your face I see. It's just her. You were here, and then you were gone. What do you want?
It was not easy for me to come here, Dark Harden. But I had one thing I felt I needed to say to you.
See them again. Oh. Thank you, Douglas. That's one special little lady you've got there. I'm glad Jerry died.
I'm glad Jerry died.
Eiffel Tower!
Before you go, Jen, I know it was you. You broke my heart.
Shut up. Oh, you've cheered up.
I'm feeling a lot better, Jen. Thanks. Thanks to a certain elfin queen.
Aw, Moss is such a good friend.
What happened to Fredo in the film?
The Godfather hasn't killed.
I'm gonna go home. I'm not feeling too good.
No, you're gonna fall right next to him, right?
Problem solved!
Oh shit, it didn't work.
The Did that hurt though?
Or just barely missed her. Oh.
Alright, that was episode 1 of season 4 of IT Crowd. And man, it started off a little slow. Started off a little slow for me, a little dry. But then, man, like the show typically does, though, they do normally pick it up in the second half, towards the end. I mean, it get going once you get the beginning established of what's going to get popping off and to go. And this was no different right here. This one started off slow, but it was just giving you all the backstory of what was to come, of what you needed to know, of what was going to happen. And then it ramped up really good. It got really funny. I mean, I thought it was very creative the way that that they did it with the storytelling and the Godfather type of thing. Both things came into fruition and it all worked for me at the end. So I had a good time with this episode and it was funny. So I'm glad to see the team back on their damn P's and Q's like they were in season 2 opener for sure. And this is seems like we off to a good start for season 4. So can't wait to see the next one.
Yeah, I love this opening episode. I think they did such a great job of layering the jokes as far as introducing them early on and then having them show back up at the end in such a well-executed way.
Yeah.
The goodbye with Roy, as far as her never saying goodbye, I thought was really good. The callback to Friedel from Godfather was well done, too. I don't know who I would give the MVP award. I want to give it to Jen just because she bossed up and like played that role as far as being Friedel so well. It just had me dying. Like, yeah. She just completely committed to being a pimp. And I thought that was really funny. But I think I might have to give it to Moss for coming through and giving Roy closure in a way that allows him to kind of move past. I thought it was so freaking sweet the way that he set that all up. And the Dungeons and Dragons whole setup was hilarious as far as getting the other guys, the Johns and the other guy, to getting them from, I don't get it, to being so freaking hyped and obsessed, yeah. And now they want to do it all the time. It was so great. It reminded me a lot of the Community episode when they did Dungeons and Dragons 2, which I think was also a very creative episode. But really loved it. I thought it was a great way to get back into the show. It's been a few months since we finished season 3.
Yeah.
Glad you guys voted it back in so we can knock out this final season. And looking forward to some more laughs.
Yep. All right. Well, look, thank you guys again for watching another Real Talk Reaction for the IT Crowd season 4, episode number 1. And until next time, people, peace.